Tonight we're here to celebrate the second year of Art in Residence. We've invited family, staff, participants and members of the public to see some of the works that we used in the discussion sessions and some of the work produced in the practical art making sessions too. This year we developed on the findings from the first year and decided that the discussion sessions were really distinctive and that we wanted to carry on doing those and see if the same sense of well-being and group cohesion could be generated with a different group. And based on the findings for the practical art making group, we decided to take those sessions up to the unit and to try them with people who had a more advanced level of dementia, so that it might be more sensory or it might be more about seeing what other people are doing and engaging that way. We also trialled much smaller scale discussion sessions, a couple of residents and a facilitator, and we didn't use replicas, we used just handouts. So it was a much more intimate conversational style of session and they worked really well. We were concerned again with replicability, how this would work somewhere that perhaps has less funding or resource. So scaling down the sessions and looking at the logistics of them was really important this year.
The researchers found that using works from the Ben Uri collection, we've managed to inspire really interesting, nuanced and meaningful discussion between the research participants. It's really important we're able to include people in the later stages of dementia and look at the impact of the creative activities on them.
Art in Residence at Nightingale has been a really useful test site which will enable us to take this programme to new partners, starting with two this year and upscaling from there.
It's been a very exciting year for us to explore how we can develop the project with the staff team, and we've been working on our dementia care unit with two members of staff. Together, they've worked so well with MR Facilitator to build up their skills and find a degree of empowerment to lead sessions on their own. We've been able to introduce two new projects, and that's silk painting and screen printing, which were in direct response to the work that Emma engaged with last year. And so we're able to have that degree of legacy and sustainability within the project.
Art in Residence comes under the remit of Ben Uri Arts and Dementia Institute, which launched in January 2019. And its aims are to generate a body of research which evidences the positive impact of art sessions like these, so that we can roll them out at care homes across the country in a replicable, cost-effective way.
People arrive at Nightingale and they have dementia, and we don't actually get to see the full person, but what Ben Uri has actually provided is a platform for them to actually be able to relate to art and extract some feelings out of them that seem to be locked within that person because of dementia.
It was a very pleasant experience. The paintings, one or two were a bit radical. Some of them were absolutely beautiful.
I feel that there's a group of people who are helping me, and every time I do something better, it's better for me to be able to show to other people.
Emma done tremendous work, and people, they get enthusiastic. It's a very educational.
So now we'll take this time to reflect and look back on year two before we move on into our third and final year of Art in Residence.